Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Roma and welcome to our reaction to The Doors. We are going to react to the song The Wasp. And it also says Texas Radio and The Big Beat. This is our first time listening to The Wasp. It is a request of our patron Kristen. I am a little bit excited inside to listen to The Doors. It has been about, I think, a month or so that we didn't react to The Doors. And I hope it will make for a good listen to The Wasp. We also have another song of The Doors that we'll be reacting to in the same session, and that would be Wild Child, and that also is requested by the same patron. So yeah.
These are videos which songs which our patron has tested on his own channel, so we can directly safely say that we are going to listen to this now and that later, because we are very sure
that it will go online.
Our reaction video will go online, it won't get blocked. And that's what we always request our patrons to do, because it makes, whatever they want, their topmost choices, if they test it, we don't need backups. So we can directly listen to them and post our reactions online. But if it's not tested, it makes it a little difficult for us, unless it's a band we've reacted to many times. Recently we reacted to Chicago, and we heard them six, seven times before. But suddenly the one song got blocked, so
out of nowhere.
Yeah, so
it's happening recently on YouTube. YouTube is acting a little weird for some reason. One song that was cleared by the patron.
It may not be YouTube. It may be the
label.
It's the label. Yeah.
Okay.
It's label is responsible.
So yeah, we don't know where is this problem, but once in a while, not regularly, but once in a while, some things are just not going right.
Yeah, it also may be the label workers who are a little bit pissed off at times with us. Because their marketing trivia that doesn't really last in our comments for too long. We are not here to promote bands or their music. We are here to give our honest opinions on them. So your idea of a reaction and a reaction channel is a little bit twisted, twatted and different from ours. So please keep that to yourself. The Doors, The Wasp.
The Wasp.
Texas Radio and The Big Beat, either it's a concert, it's a place, it's an event, or it's part of the song title, who knows. Our patron has not cleared it out, and neither do we do research on such things. We try to keep our reaction as pure, raw, genuine and true as humanly possible, so that you get a holistic, genuine experience of what we think when we listen to it for the first time, especially if it's a first time listen by both of us. In this case, both songs we've never heard before. Let's get started.
I want to tell you about Texas Radio and The Big Beat. Comes out of the Virginia swamps, cool and slow, with plenty of precision. The backbeat, narrow and hard to master. Some call it heavenly in its brilliance, others mean and rueful of the Western dream. I love the friends I have gathered together in this thin raft. We have constructed pyramids in honor of our escaping. This is the land where the Pharaoh died. Negroes in the forest, brightly feathered, they are saying, forget the night, live with us in forests of azure. Out here in the perimeter, there are no stars. Out here, we is stone, immaculate. Now listen to this, I'll tell you about the heartache. I'll tell you about the heartache and the loss of God. I'll tell you about the hopeless night. The soul's forgot. I'll tell you about the maiden with wrought iron soul. I tell you this, no eternal reward will forgive us now for wasting the dawn. I tell you about Texas radio and the big beat. Soft, driven, slow and mad like some new language.
Outstanding. The music in this was so rich and vibrant, it was absolutely wow, amazing to listen to.
What is it called? It's called the Texas Radio, the Big Beat.
This is absolutely of incredibly high level of music on display here. Incredible, especially that organ player, especially the guitarist, the drummer, the vocalist, everything was quite incredible here. It was I wouldn't put in the guitarist in there, it was not that strong, but the organ and the drums.
Yeah, definitely. That's right.
Amazing.
The guitarist had to accompany.
Wow, beautifully done. I don't care too much about the lyrics because I don't really connect with them. Being from a totally different part of the world, being from I don't get it. Do you?
That's what I'm saying. Both of us I'm talking about. And I'm going to come to that.
I don't get it at all. The N-word used there, the earlier version of the N-word. It was a long time ago. I guess at that time it was allowed and permitted for Caucasian gentlemen such as Jim Morrison to use it.
To say that.
Yeah, so I think at that time it was permitted.
Yeah.
It probably was till the mid-80s.
Oh, so late.
It was
okay.
Allowed. This is the first version of the N-word.
Mm-hmm.
Second version probably by the late 70s it was starting to get shunned in the US. You know, the biggest joke is in many parts of Europe, till today the N-word is used.
Because in Spanish there is no other name for the color black, right?
They don't, not Spanish as such, I'm saying in general. They don't really know how bad it is. And if, you know, the blacks really care so much about the N-word being used against them or for them, they should stop using it themselves for each other.
Yeah.
They refer to each other so commonly, especially stand-up comedians, especially those in the entertainment industry, entertainment sector in the US primarily. They use it so regularly, almost every minute they use the N-word, you know, with reference to other blacks, of course. But they use it so frequently that you can't blame other communities who don't have knowledge, especially if they don't have knowledge about the culture and things that to use it themselves, because you keep using it in your interviews and stand-up specials. For example, recently it was not even a stand-up comedy special, it was a stand-up serious special by Dave Chappelle. It was a mockery of a stand-up comedy special on Netflix. It was posted on Netflix as a joke, but it was nothing serious about it, just marketing his brand, marketing his name, and talking about an event where it would get him a lot of publicity, pretending to support it, but at the same time you're not really supporting it. The fact is, he used the N-word so often. For someone like me who's in India, I'm tempted to use it even by mistake. And I'm not responsible for it. When you use it so often, how dare you blame someone else for using it on you?
Have you seen a rush hour scene where they go to this place, some, you know, inside place where Jackie Chan happens to call the black guy with the N-word, thinking it's cool because it's his first time in USA or something like that. His partner is, what's his name?
And how unscrupulously they start a fight with him.
I know this stuff.
You know, certain things should be taught in school and should be taught at home. That there should
it's
be,
basic understanding.
If you think someone else is being racist towards you,
you're
even worse when you reply with violence. When you reply with so much violence and the person is totally unaware why you're being violent, you're even worse than what they ever would do to you. So, you know.
That's exactly what happens to people from these countries who have not been to the US and maybe they didn't even have much exposure to Western movies, especially from Hollywood.
I've trained and coached and counseled thousands of people from third world nations. You know, most of them have no clue about American culture.
Yeah.
And not that there is too much to talk about. I don't even know one single movie or documentary or show which actually talks in depth about American culture. And I'm saying that having a lot of love for America, the music of America, the movies of America, watching it all my life, I feel very sad that no one in America ever thought of making a series or documentaries or movies about your own culture. So not many people who I have coached, trained personally and I know intimately because we talk about personal topics during our sessions, not many of them know anything about the N-word or anything about America. And it's sad. It's sad because, you know, you treat us in such a racial way when we come there without even realizing that we may not be aware about you. We may know only little bit, whatever was good enough to know on our travel, in our travel guide or through some basic research on YouTube and other such platforms. So, you know, I don't know what this song is about, but excellent music.
It was about, he named it, I think the music that they were playing, that's what he was calling Texas Radio and the Big Beat. I'll show you how it sounds and then they would play the music. There are two kinds of musicians, so maybe there are more kinds of musicians. What I'm talking about is these two kind of musicians. One who knows how to create music, he can visualize it, he can think it, he can create it. That is what Jim Morrison and the Doors were. And there are those musicians who are there by fluke in the music industry. What their motivation is the outcome of the music, not the music itself. So they are there for the stardom, they are there for the celebrity status, they are there for all the glitz, but they may not know how to create good music. The basic product, they have no clue about. When you listen to something like this, you get the difference between the two.
Yeah, that's it for this one. We'll continue this conversation or talk about other things in our next few videos. Make sure you join us for that if you like what we are talking about or you find it interesting or it connects with you in any way. The lyrics didn't connect with me too much, but apparently Kirti got it.
No, I didn't get it.
You got
I didn't get it.
It's about the Texas Radio and the Big Beat.
That's what
that much
said.
I know, the Wasp. I'm assuming the Wasp is some, it's a term for a particular radio station
okay.
or something from that part of the world. That's it for this one. Goodbye.